What do you see as your most urgent priorities within this approach to try to reach the SDGs?
Well, that depends per country. For example, the richer countries maybe have combated poverty and hunger, but there is a huge challenge in order to reduce CO2 emissions in order to make industries better suit to the 21st century when it comes to the respect to environment and climate. But in poorer countries, maybe one of the main priorities is health and education, because without health and education, you cannot build an economy, you cannot build a society. So the priorities differ from country to country. As a result of the differences where countries stand, the agenda for country A might be another agenda as for country B. But all together, they have to pursue these sustainable development goals. So the instrument we developed is an instrument where you can see where your country is standing on the indicators. You can compare yourself with peers. You can see who to learn from, etc. So it is an instrument for the countries, but also for other actors to work with.
But how can you enforce these goals?
Well, to realize these goals, you really need governmental and political action. Now, the political action is not something that comes from just from itself. It comes from leaders and it comes from pressure from society. And here our instrument is meant to contribute to the leaders who are willing, and also it is meant to help other actors in society to put pressure on political actors to say, well, hey, you know, your country or this country is well underway, but what about the infrastructure? What about the quality of the ocean, etc.? So the report is meant to be an instrument, an equipment for NGOs, for private business, for media, in order also to put pressure on political leaders and governments.
So if you would give an example for somebody who watches this interview, would like to know what he or she can do on a very individual basis, you would say talk to the governments, pressure the governments, and maybe open your pocketbook?
I would say look at your country notes, or the country where you happen to live, or where you feel familiar, or where your roots. Look at something that you can relate to that gives you the passion or the compassion. Maybe you have a compassion with education, or with health, or with with energy, with clean energy. And then you look at the indicators. You know, start an alliance. Address the government, see what you can do in your own position as a researcher, as an NGO, as a journalist. Everybody can contribute by addressing the urgency, but also to provide governments with good policy advice. We need it badly, because the clock is ticking. We are living in 2017. 2030 is only 12 and a half years away.
When you look at Germany, how would you rate what's happening in Germany right now?
Germany is definitely in the top 10 of the ranking in this dashboard, but Germany also has huge challenges to face. We can talk about the damage that the German industry still causes for the climate and the environment. And this is a long-term process, but we can also address some spillover effects. Well, the global industry, not only in Germany, is benefiting from tax evasion. And if we could only combat this tax evasion more effectively, then we would have a lot more money to help the poorest countries. So there is an agenda for every country.
You see the negative spillover effects, but also positive spillover effects when it comes to maybe what the more wealthy countries can do, right?
Yeah, in this year's edition, we addressed also the spillover effects, and these are the economic effects that are not included in market prices. So what you can think of is that a product that is produced in Indonesia but it is sold in the UK, maybe gives a good quality of life in the UK, but it also gives a damage to the situation of the forests in Borneo. Now, these spillover effects do not appear on the balance sheet of the UK, but appear on the balance sheet of Indonesia. And to address them, we need more global action, and we need also support from the richer country to the poorest countries, because it is not included in the market prices. So we need a corrective mechanism in order to address the spillover effects. We also have positive spillover effects like tourism. Money from the richer countries are brought to the poorer countries, which is good. It brings jobs, etc., etc. there. But also there you have to think of what this tourism is creating in the areas of the poorer countries, and how it really can contribute to a development where all benefit and not just some.
Let's talk briefly about what a foundation like the Bertelsmann Foundation can contribute in that process. Where do you see your main role in that?
Well, as Bertelsmann Stiftung, we are politically neutral, but what we could do in our neutrality, we could develop some methodology in order to put together some data and analytics in order to present a kind of a mirror for the countries and say, well, this is where you stand, and this is pioneering work. So we also love to cooperate, and we welcome all kind of comments in order to improve our methodology. But together with the Sustainable Development Solutions Network, which are 140 universities in the world, we try to at least to bring the evidence base that is necessary for an objective and an informed debate on how to pursue the Sustainable Development Goals.
Is it sometimes hard to be politically neutral when it comes to this fight for reaching these goals?
Yes, I think that that as a person, and that is true for Jeffrey Sachs and for myself, and for all others who work on it, as a person, you can hardly be neutral, and I think you should not be neutral. But that is not to say that we bring in our report. We concentrate on the evidence, and this is the analytical base, so that it could be helpful for as well for the government of China, for the government of South Africa, for the NGOs in Latin America, for the researchers in the US, etc. So the report is neutral, but yes, of course, I'm personally very much committed also to do what I can. Even as a citizen, I have a political opinion.
Mr. De Geus, thank you very much for your time.